You're listening to the voice of IWA Flip here on InterFed Radio. Welcome to Sounds of the Revolution, pay-per-view preview edition. With me today in studio, as always, Commissioner Sean McAbee, Brandon Hello. Madden.
Hey.
And special guest, Commissioner Scott Anderson. Hey.
Hey. Welcome. Thanks for having me, guys.
Oh, man. You know what? Sorry to out you, Commissioner, as a as a manager in the RWL. But hey, things happen.
That's okay. I'm not hiding.
He is a connoisseur of the bronze.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yes.
But now, Commissioner Sean McAbee has. I got the message a few moments ago, and he finally revealed. The card for
Goddess of War Games.
The Goddess of War Games.
Yes.
Now, a lot going on here in the RWL, man. I say that a lot's going on everywhere, but the RWL is probably it's amongst the bronze leagues that are just elevating the Bronze Federation to new levels, and Commissioner, like I said, you just passed your 1 year anniversary. We're moving into this. New era of the Revolution Wrestling. Obviously, if you haven't heard, Commissioner has secured a title, an actual belt, for the winner of our Wrestler of the Year. The actual, how did you say it, Sean? The Real Elite?
The Real Elite.
The Real Elite title is coming. Oh, man. So, yeah, Commissioner, I mean, we have a lot of show to cover, so I kind of want to get right into it. I know this is a preview for our pay-per-view coming up. Managers that are in the RWL, like I said, this is something that we're going to try to kind of get you guys the pay-per-view action, get a little highlight for all the matches coming up. And, Sean, I don't think we've talked about this, but, I kind of want to start with this in terms of, a question for me to you in terms of, what's your main goal for the preview? I mean, because the way I see it or the way I kind of take from it is that, managers are going to get to see their matches, who they're going up against and kind of, I'm hoping, include it in their trash talk.
Yes, that's the main goal. That's a lot of these matches are already in feuds right now. And some of these I'm trying to start feuds, nice. See if these managers actually do something with these matches,
Yeah, because Scott mentioned that there's a couple, names maybe that are, I saw it too, and I saw a few names that are new to the league, and I'm like, wow, they got a pay-per-view match? Like, oh, man, if my name's not on this.
Yeah, I left you out, Flip. So.
On purpose. You're like, on purpose. Oh, I love it. Oh, no, but, to get to it, the first names that I saw on this, I know there's two cards that are soon to be released on the Facebook page, or are they going to wait till the bulletin to drop it?
Sometime this week.
Sometime. Okay. Perfect. Yeah. Perfect.
Probably Monday. So.
Now, our first match that we're looking over, or that I'm looking over here on that first card, is a set of newcomers. I mean, we have the, and I love it when managers come in and they, kind of quote unquote, give them their crew or their, I don't want to say their gang, their, and I always can, their faction.
Their faction, yeah.
For a while I was saying fraction and people are like, you're really not into wrestling, you nerd.
You're the numbers guy.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh man. Yeah. So yep. these two new factions to the RWL. Came on strong. I know one of the managers through the interactions or through the Facebook posting, I know was a new manager that had been gone from the IWA. So, I to see his names on here was awesome. It's like, hey, that's what you want to see when you come back to the game. You want to see your characters, involved in something right away. So I thought that was awesome. So shout out to Swindler Hillary Clinton. Stone Cold Barbara Bush, Insane Mary Todd, and they're going up against. I mean, I got to get your thoughts on this one, guys. I mean, the X-Men.
Yes. as in EX, X-Men. So they don't have those dangly bits anymore. So.
Oh, man.
Now, there's no discriminating in the RWL.
That's what I was waiting for. There's no discriminating. So, hey, you know what? As long as you're trash talking and if you're willing to, you know, run an angle and bring it, then bring it.
And they are actual women now, so.
So
if the Olympics could do it, the RWL could do it.
Nice. So the we still haven't got any clarification. Scott, do you know PA, the PA stable? Have they said anything from what you can tell on the RWL?
Nope. From what I can tell, I haven't seen anything.
You know what? They actually
helpful there.
No. Actually, they just trash talked this cycle, and I think they beat up Alexis Rose. The man Brandi Lynch and Alexis Styles.
That's right. Yep, Alexis Styles, which they are no longer in the league now.
Yeah,
they retired.
So they beat him up so bad they left.
They retired. Yeah.
Nice.
That's rough.
Send them packing.
I can't say it. No, I won't say it. Okay. So the X-Men. The X-Men are here, and that's and they're going up against the president's wives or the PAs. You know, they're going up
first
against them.
First ladies of wrestling.
Yes. I like it. That's first what we're going to start calling them around here. Good job. The first ladies of wrestling are going up against the X-Men. Joanna Legs, Weezy Snipes, and Michelle Tyson. Oh, man.
And this is actually the first War Games match, because there's three War Games matches.
Nice. Now, for those IWA fans out there that are ignorant, like myself, to wrestling and War Games, can you explain? I mean, I think I got an idea to, like, a War Games match style, but, you know, if there's any other IWA, you know, people out there that don't know anything about wrestling, what can you tell us about a War Games match?
Yeah, go ahead, Brandon. You're better.
So basically, it's, you know, me and Sean, we were watching wrestling when we were younger. It was more so we were into the NWA, and the War Games was two rings wrapped in steel, you know, submission or surrender. You know, it wasn't like NXT where they took the top off the cage, or how TNA kind of threw it all into one ring. This is going to be two rings with a cage around it, and, you know, just beat each other up until somebody gives up.
Nice. Holy moly. That's a hard way to you come into the league, and that's the way you're gonna get introduced. Like, wow.
You know, as Dusty Rhodes said, violence for the sake of violence.
Nice. All right, nice. So, you know, good luck to all those RWL newcomers, and I guess whoever makes it out alive can hang around. nice. So next on the slate, we got Jungle Girl. Oh, man, that's not fair. Oh, that's what I'm about. Hey, there you go. I like it. Jungle Girl with Pebbles going up against Jack Hammett, Jessica Andre.
Jack Hammer, Jessica. Yeah, that's a new person. Just come in. Yeah.
Nice. Nice. And you said that's a new fighter, right? And then, stable designation? Yeah. Or none, huh? Nice. Freelancers.
And we do have to be aware, right, that Jungle Girl has Pebbles.
Yes. Pebbles will be a factor in that match. Guaranteed. Now, have we got any word? Is Pebbles like Jake the Snake's a pet? Like in a what am I trying to say? What's the word? In a bag? In a canvas sack? Or?
As far as I know, she just carries it around her neck.
Oh, nice. All right, cool. So watch out for that ringside corner.
Probably just hangs around ringside.
Yeah. Yeah, right. Watch out for that ringside corner. Yeah. Nice.
Hang around the announce table.
What was one of your announcers?
Johnny C.
Nice. Yeah. Hey, so you see, all that time, Johnny C's thought, what's her name, was playing footsies with him, but I guess it was doubles. Oh, nice. All right. So, yeah, Jungle Girl versus Jack Hammer, Jessica Andre. Wow, like I said, you know, I think the hype is around Jungle Girl, and I think we all want to see her succeed. So, you know,
She just wants blood for Pebbles.
There you go.
That's her main goal.
You know, I feel sorry for Jessica Andre then, because All right. So, okay. Now this is one of our most, or one of the more hyped up, you know, feuds we got coming into this one. And this is, Izzy Crimson going up against Miss Fortune.
Those FTs, you know, they're going to show those misfits, you know, exactly who's the misfits of the RWL.
Nice.
Fear and Torment's here.
Yeah, and the girls from Fear and Torment, you know, started off the year, you know, nice and hot, you know. But I mean, I never count out the misfits, man, because you know they've been known to be an RWL you know stronghold, and it almost seems like as if they rose to the occasion. You know, they were here, you know, from the start. They kind of, you know, held their own throughout the year. And then as things started heating up, they were like, hey, we're not going to, you know, fall too far behind. So don't ever count us out. And, you know, ever since then, I think, you know, that was their reminder. So.
Right. Miss Fortune, she's coming off the national title victory, right?
Yep.
Nice. And Izzy took her own national, right?
No.
Ah, okay. I got that wrong. Dang it. Who? Oh, it was Juju. Fuck. Dang it.
Yep, Juju.
All right. So, but it's still going to be, I mean, Izzy, I'm trying to think what Izzy, Izzy's been on the title page the last couple, right? Izzy won.
Yeah, she's been doing pretty good. Titles here and there, six man, some singles.
I have something in the back of my head, and I can't, you know, quite, you know, wrap my head around it.
She's Ivory champ right now.
Okay, that's what it is. And she was also the one that lost in the contender max, right? Right. Versus
yes.
That's what it was. Nice. Ah.
I know that I've been paying attention to what Izzy has going on.
Oh!
Definitely, like that first picture. That first picture came out. Yeah. I was like, huh. Might be some rebellion girls that keep
that,
an eye on.
You know what? There you go. Good way to spark the light bulb.
Yeah,
she defeated what's her name in the Mohawk match.
Well, and she won the hardcore match.
Yep.
Izzy did.
Aha. That's the one. That's the one that was in the back of my head. I go, I know I had something that we just talked about for Izzy. It was that Mohawk.
Yeah,
it'll be future. Interesting if that was a one and done or if there's more to come.
There's probably more to come, I believe.
Oh man! Now have we got a? Do we have an update as terms of color of Mohawk for the pay per view? No.
Green.
It's gonna be a green one. Nice.
Green Mohawk
for the pay per view. But watch out, Miss Fortune. Green Mohawk, Izzy Crimson coming at you. Now, I mean, this young lady here, we've known her for a while now, and the starlet Liberty Monroe has brought her rebellion to the RWL. And needless to say, like I said, I mean, obviously, you know, we asked for it, and sure enough, we got it in. What do you call it? Not encyclopedia format, but it was well documented, I guess you could say. You know, because you know, her winning streaks and her titles from other leagues were it was awesome. You know, it was awesome to see her her resume is the word I'm looking for.
Yeah, impressive display of awesome. You know.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, I mean, to me, this is what the IWA is made of. You have someone that's already, you know, made a name and said, all right, cool, there's a challenge for me. I see the new challenge. Here I go. Bam.
Right.
Lays out the resume. Bam. It's like, okay, cool. And like you said, we asked for it. It's not like she was showing off. We said, what, you know, I want to know. We want to know. All right, cool. There it is. Awesome. Now we have our starlets here in the RWL that are saying, all right, cool. Let me try and, you know, make, you know, make a mark on her. You know, let me try to, I don't want to say get over on her, but at least, hey, you know what? Let me test the water.
Yeah.
You know, and yeah, this is what the IWA is made out of, because, you know, challenges are made, but, you know, I think in this, and I'm going to say it this way, and some people might, you know, be like, huh? But I think in this new IWA, and, you know, kind of what you're doing, Sean, I've always been a fan of since I started this InterFed stuff, is the use of social media and the use of communicating and, you know, quote unquote, breaking the fourth law and working behind scenes to push forward a better product.
Yeah, I'm trying to use every tool that we have available, you know.
Oh, yeah. And when we find managers, you know, that, you know, are in that same realm, I think it elevates our product. And, you know, that being said, you know, it's still a play-by-mail game. So you still have managers that are in that category, someone like Sky Rose. So now you bridge in the generation gap between players that are playing strictly play-by-mail with people that are playing, you know, in social media and using all their tools and just bringing it all together, Sean. And I think that's awesome, man. And then in this match is just that, you know, to me, it's one of those dream matchups, you know, because now is all of a sudden we have, you know, the starlet Liberty Monroe here, you know, a newcomer that comes with credentials. You have someone that's an RWL veteran like Sky Rose that has her own RWL credentials. And bam, now we got a pay-per-view match.
Yeah, I'm going to see who's going to reach higher, you know.
Yeah.
Awesome. Starlet of the Stars or Sky Rose, is the sky the limit there, or is she going to go higher, you know?
Nice. Now, Scott, do you know something about this starlet, Liberty Monroe, and what's going on, and what's going on behind the scenes with her?
Well, sure. I do. For those of you who may not know, despite Flip's kindness and trying not to reveal anything I don't want to reveal, I do manage the Rebellion, including Liberty Monroe. So, to that end, what is her? What was your question again?
Just what's going on with her? I love it. Just what's going on with her leading up to the pay-per-view.
Okay. Well, for Liberty in particular, she's had a bit of a string of bad luck. So I think for her, this match represents a chance to put on a good match, a good showing, and hopefully a good victory on a stage as big as Goddess of War Games. She really needs a big win. And to get a big win over a top talent like Sky Rose would definitely be a boost for her kind of getting back into the main event scene.
Nice. Now, I mean, she has, I mean, let's say it like it is. I mean, the Rebellion and your other faction there. I mean, wow. I mean, I'm afraid to ask. But I kind of already, I think I know that you run the Insects also.
Me?
Yeah, no?
I no.
Oh, come on, you're already outing yourself. Just say you run the Insects, for crying out.
I don't.
Oh, man.
You know what?
I don't. I have six. I have the Rebellion and I have the Gores.
You guys like the way I try to sneak that one on him, huh?
Hey, you know what?
Where is he going with this?
I don't know, but you could have two more.
I could have two more, but I keep hoping, and I know this is silly, but I keep hoping that the IWA is going to change their mind, and I want one less manager over six. So sure. I'm going to keep it at six because the IWA should really reconsider.
They should.
But I'll say about that. I don't mean to bring up any.
I want to third and fourth that motion. Can I get eyes? Aye.
Yeah. I don't know. Me, and I've said as much before, but I just think that was a slam dunk, and I don't know how they goofed that up. But anyway, nope, I do not run the Insects. Sorry.
You don't manage Beloved either?
I do not.
Oh, man. One of these guys.
I have my six.
Well, I don't manage Juju either.
Stop.
Oh, nice. That's awesome.
Yeah.
All righty. Well, that you know what? That's one part of one third of the rebellion is yours, and another third of the rebellion is in our next matchup. And
You skipped a match.
Uh-oh.
You're on Etzel Frost versus Misleading.
Ah, maybe I got a different version of it, because on mine it's well, anyways, if you want to do that one, we'll do that.
I see Erica Rockwell versus Gabby Wonder.
Okay. Then I guess I got the other version. Okay.
You got the new version. Well, yours is the – well, as long
you
as –
you guys got the right version.
Well,
let me turn
as
the page.
As long as the match recovery is the right match.
Yeah,
so the next match is now this isn't a rematch, right? This is a new matchup because at the last pay-per-view, we had Gabby versus Starlight, I believe, right? Or is this round two for Gabby and the Deviant?
This is round two, I believe.
It is two.
Yeah.
Oh man, I lost way too many brain cells on vacation, man. Oh my goodness. Okay.
No, you're right. It was Starlight.
It was Starlight. See, my brain cells are coming back.
Yeah, they're back.
They're coming back slowly. They're regenerating themselves slowly. Okay, so
yeah,
this is
they've been jabbing at each other, these two.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. These two. Oh man. Now this is another one of those. Even I'm trying my hardest to not, you know, force myself into matchups against this manager and everywhere I go.
Well, you beat me the last time, no?
Oh man.
Yeah.
Man.
But you know, the thing that I feel, and I don't know, Flip, if you feel this way too, but I feel like Rockwell versus Wonder is a similar type. Storyline to Captain America and Iron Man, where you're not really saying either one is necessarily bad, but they just have different philosophies. And so those philosophies are butting heads. So even though neither one is necessarily, you know,
over a little word.
Yeah.
That I'm not going to pay to the jar to say. Oh yeah, awesome.
You know, just these differing philosophies.
But see, now I got to ask, because now we're on the air, and you know, I what was it early on? It was early on. I think, dang it! Now I got to go back and look. But I think one of the girls mentioned your at large faction. And now that you brought it back, I'm tempted to mention it again. And I was like, no, I don't want to mention the at-large stuff. I just want to keep it to the rebellion. I'm not going to call them the bitches are back in town. I won't say it. I won't say it. You know, but I was like, I was like, oh, that B-word, I'm telling you.
You know, it's funny that you say that, though, because I wondered as I added those stable initials if I wanted to make it a G instead of a B, and I'm like, no, it's all got to match up. I don't want there to be any confusion, you know, with the people who track points.
Right.
I'm like, but they're not boys. But now we've solved this problem, so thank you.
Oh yeah. The rebellion came in. They addressed that, you know, pretty strongly in their trash talk. So
they own it.
They own it. Yeah. So go get it. Nice. So now, next one on my.
And let's face it, they're making enough money where they can put money in the swear jar.
Ah, I like it. There you go. And oh yeah, I won't. No, we'll leave that for the off air. So okay. Now, next on our lineup, I mean these two. I mean, you got, you know, someone coming off of you know, what did Etzel just won league? No.
She just won the Battle Royal.
Battle Royal. Yeah, so Etzel just won.
No, she has a chance at Revolt X.
Yeah, so she has the chance to lose to Susie Moon next month.
Hey, that's if Susie's still the champion. That's
yes. There may or may not have been a tie this month.
Yeah.
Dun dun dun. Nice. Okay. Well,
now, help me out here. Which Frost recently hit the IWA report?
It wasn't me.
Didn't one of the Frosts just hit the IWA report this cycle?
No, yeah, that was Elsa.
Yeah, I hit with Vlada first last cycle.
Vlada hit it.
I think you could, I mean, and yeah, those FT girls, man. Yeah, it's Edsel Frost and it's Elsa.
Yeah,
they're both close.
So was it Elsa then?
Elsa
did. Yes.
Okay.
But FT is Fear and Torment, not Frost.
So the two Frost women
they're not Frost.
There's only one Frost. Edsel Frost. Elsa is Hurst.
What?
Who came up with this?
Oh yeah.
Who booked this?
That's right.
Oh yeah, we did that. You know,
sorry.
Our like I said, that was I told Sean, I need some more different names. I go, my names are all gonna come out the same. She's probably gonna end up being called like, you know, jumping Julie or something. I go, help me out. So Sean hooked me up, brother. Sean's like, here you go, brother, here you go. So I had a
Stone in Elsa Hurst form.
Oh yeah. I had to borrow some ideas. I go, let me get some. But
all right. My bad. You know when the teacher says there are no dumb questions, I feel like I just proved that wrong. Okay, go ahead.
Oh yeah, join the club there. That's all I do here all day.
They're even listed right next to each other. Medusa and Widow's Peak champion.
Nice. All
right. Okay.
Nice. Okay. Here we go. Back to the goddess of war pay per view. We got Elsa Frost and Misleading. And like I said, we can't say enough about the Misfits, man. The Misfits, you know, have proven themselves, you know, pay per view after pay per view. And are they the current champ? No. Oh no. Who took it this one? Why did I go blank? Susie took it this one.
Susie got it, yeah.
Susie. Holy moly.
Susie Blood Moon.
Yeah. Yeah, but now she took it from Leading? Why do I have Miss Leading as a champion? Was she champion last cycle? See, I'm all off. I'm still...
I'm about to tell you. Winter.
Ah, it was Winter last cycle.
Yep.
For some reason, you know, if you say RWL, you can either say Misleading or one of the Gores, and I think you'll be close. Oh, man. You know, that are those damn NRA girls. Gee. Give somebody else a chance.
I will say, before I joined the RWL, I kind of, you know, would peek in once in a while because I had my women's wrestlers in another league. And I always thought if I did come to a women's league, it was going to have to be the RWL. And the Misfits, you know, with Misfortune, Misleading, were one of the groups that I recognized as I was kind of peeking in before I came in. So definitely a group that has made their mark.
Now, just, you know, since you're mentioning them, have you crossed paths with them in other leagues
with the Misfits?
Yeah, or have they always been in RWL?
Yeah. They as far as I know, I haven't seen them any place other than the RWL.
No, they started with issue 1, I believe. So.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. She did.
Here since the beginning.
The Misfits.
That is right. She did say that in her trash talk. They've been here since the beginning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nice. All right. Yeah,
it'll be an uphill battle for Edsel Frost, no doubt about that.
Yeah, something about those FT girls, though, man. It's just, you know, they like Scott was saying. It's like, I mean, dude, they're so confusing that you don't know. You know, how do you know that one of them's not going to come to the ring and, you know, do the you know, hide under the ring or come out of the fans or, as a, you know, watch out, Misleading. You know, bring some of the other Misfits because you could need them.
I think Edsel is far better looking than Elsa.
What? Oh, man. Yeah.
I mean, depending on taste, you know what I'm saying?
When did this become a beauty pageant? Like, gee.
If you're into the girl from the ring, yeah, I mean, that's Elsa. I mean, Elsa's probably your chick, you know.
Right.
I'm gonna start bringing bags for all of them. Dude. Have Slammerella. I'm gonna buy a souvenir Slammerella paper bags for all of them. You can wear them if they want them.
The Slammerella bags are a hot selling item at the concession stands.
Oh man! Now, I see the next one listed. Is this our next War Games match?
Yes, it is.
Nice.
This is the Order versus the
Divas Inc.
Divas Inc. I was about Divas to
say Inc. versus the Order.
Now is Divas nice. Inc. A quote unquote a slash a fraction of faction of part of the Beautiful People?
Yes.
Aha. Nice. So see that I mean, I know sometimes it gets a little crazy because you start slashing, you know, 100 things, but you know.
Well, they're under different names, but they're pretty much closely related. So.
Aha. Okay. So, but they are their own entity, the Divas.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, cool. So we'll keep it at Divas. We won't refer to them so as to not confuse them. But so here we got Sexy Savannah Ray, Beautiful Brandi Davis, and Fabulous Missy Davis going up in a War Games match against Double G, Glenda Gilbert. Okay, cool. Okay, good. Amazing Amy Blitz and Deadly Darlene Blitzy?
I think it's Blitz.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, cool. Now, and you said they were Order.
Yes. They're Order. So there's a set of sisters. In Divas Inc., there's a set of sisters in there. So.
Nice. I like it. Now, I mean, Order, I mean, there are three cycles.
About three
cycles since they're okay. So this is their first pay-per-view match, and this is the Divas Inc.'s first pay-per-view match.
No,
I think they were on the last show.
Yeah, they were in the dark matches.
Aha! Now, and those were the late minute entry, the last minute entries that we got on the last time.
Yes,
I love it.
And the Facebook.
All right, well. Well, they moved up in time slots, so you guys are doing something right, Divas Inc. So that's the way it works around here. You move up in slot, and then, you know, hey, make a name for yourself. There we go. But, I mean...
Yeah, trying to win a chance here, you know, in this RWL.
Oh, yeah, I mean, and you know, not only that, but, I mean... You know, we've asked Order, and I think this cycle they responded, right? They actually had some trash talk. Because, guys, I mean, that ultimately, you know, we know our audience. We know you guys are listening. You know, if you're not trash talking, you know, if you pull an IWA flip and fall asleep on your computer and don't get your trash talk in, then, you know, hey, watch out the next pay-per-view.
You know what? That's an easy 5 points.
Don't remind me, dude. It's bad enough I'm over here, you know.
They're the only 5 points I got this cycle.
That was more than some of my. I was like, gosh.
Remember, if you enter the battle royal, you get points also.
Oh, yes.
6 points.
And I think I managed to remember to send the ones that I think I did. I think I was sending them in, and I was like, I got to send these two in at least. Darn it! All right. Now we get to the second card, and you know, after the intermission, do they still have intermissions? No, they don't have movie intermissions. Though?
I know New Japan still has intermissions.
Aha!
Aha. Sure, we'll adopt that, right?
Yeah, I was gonna say that's a good promotion to copy off of.
Yeah, actually, I think WWE still has intermission. They just call it a Bobby Lashley match, though. So.
Oh. Do you remember like the old Summer Slams, how they would do like that intermission on the pay per view?
Yeah.
Anybody remember that?
I do. I remember the intermissions. Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah. I think SummerSlam and WrestleMania they'd have intermissions, and you'd have to sit and wait for like 15 minutes for them to come back on.
Nice.
And you wondered, I'm paying how much for this?
Right. This intermission? Yeah. The show's only 2.5 hours long. Let's go.
$39.99.
Nice.
Yes.
Okay, so we have after our intermission, we have our Contender X match.
Yes.
And now I'm looking at this, and you know, I like I say, Sean, I mean, you'd like to give everybody a chance, you know. So, mm-hmm. you know, when I see somebody that's a newcomer getting a shot, it's like, you know, to me, I you know, I'm not going to.
She got a regional, and yeah, her point flow was up there. Nice. Like 498 or something like that. So
yeah. I mean, and like you said, it's more than anything, just that opportunity. You know, like I said, there's a lot of leagues out there, and like I said, because we revolve ours around trash talk, you know, we kind of want to give you guys something to talk about, give you guys something to mention. So, you know, when you get those opportunities, you know, do the most with them. You know, take advantage. You know, bring it up. You know. Yeah. Do something. You know what? Do something in the trash talk with it.
You know, and just looking at this car that Sean's put together, Mr. Clark, who manages the order, if you take a look, he's got three matches, three pretty high profile matches on here. So
he's been doing pretty good.
Yeah. Oh no, man. I mean, that's you know, that, and that's kind of like you know, hey, like you just said right now, Sean, you're not only going to base it on trash talk. You know, you are looking at all the other you know details in the league, like. Point flow. It's like, hey, you know what? You hit. So, hey, we're going to give you an opportunity to see if you can hit again at a pay-per-view match and make it work in your advantage. So,
and they be some pretty high-profile people. So
Nice. So we have our Contender X match, which is featuring Spitfire, Janie Briggs, going up against Alexis Rose. And like I said, we mentioned the Roses here, you know, quite often. You know, that faction there has...
That should be Aurora Rose.
Aha. So
do
we have, okay.
What do I have it right on the sheet I gave you?
The one I have says Alexis, but.
It's supposed to be Aurora.
It's Aurora. Okay, so Aurora Rose is going up against.
Yeah, I was doing last minute changes. So.
Okay.
So we are going to have to hire a new typist for the RWL.
Nice.
The staffing goes.
Nice. Now, correct me if I'm wrong.
Matches are, you know, subject to change, you know, in a blink of an eye, you know.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, Sean, but Alexis, the one that had already won her, she's the one that was the RWL, that had won in RWL's world championship, or a world championship.
She's been the world side, yes.
Yep, she has been.
Now, see, that's another thing, because she got her, you know, quote-unquote, her, you know, shined, you know, now it's time to give Aurora time to see if she can do something with it, you know. So Aurora Rose is going to be facing Spitfire Janie Briggs at our Contender X match there at Goddess of War Games, and you know, hopefully get a shot at either Susie Moon or, you know, as details unfold, you know, the new champion.
Vince McMahon's not the only one that could change matches on the fly. So.
Ah, nice. I like it. Now, next on our lineup, we got Juju Stone going up against Heather Zastępowski. And like you said, there's another one from the order.
Yes.
That has been hot. Given a shot. Yeah, given a shot to, you know, shine and going up against a former national champ.
Yes, former national champion, and Heather has actually been regional champion two cycles in a row.
Nice.
I was just gonna say that because I thought she was a two cycle in a row.
Yep.
Nice, and like you said, you know, the order has come on, and you know, they've come on strong the last couple cycles. So, you know, again, we want to hear more from you guys. Like I said, you know, get something on there. I know the order has taken to the Facebook. I know they like, you know, obviously. You know, we encourage trash talk in the bulletin. You know, Sean does a great job of cutting and pasting it and getting it into the bulletin so that everybody has a chance to, you know, to take a look at it. I know some managers, because of, you know, their lives or whatever, that's their only time to trash talk. So that's, you know, that's why they do it there. But again, we'd love to hear from you guys. And like I said, Heather's another one that has come on strong, and you know, good luck against the silent killer there, Juju Stone.
Yes.
She's been hot, yeah. Both of these have been really hot, so it's a nice matchup.
Yeah. Ah, here we go. More of these Rebellion girls, man. Yeah, you know what? And this kind of rebellion is the ones we want to see. This is what we want. You know, you got the Helion, Roxanne O'Connor, going up against Hope. And again, this is, you know, another one in that same sense, like you mentioned the last time. This is another one of those could-be Civil War, you know, moments where, hey, you know what? We got to have these Undertaker-Hogan matches. Like, we got to have these, you know, Sting versus, I went blank. Was Sting ever really a good guy? I don't know.
Sting was the ultimate good guy.
Sting versus Lex Luger.
Man, why do I have Sting pitted at like some dark? All because of the suit. Duh.
Yeah. Well, he went all crow there in the late 90s.
Towards the end. He went all crow at the end. Oh, nice.
But I'm just hoping not to go 0-3 at the pay-per-view. when the lights are on bright, I'd like to win one. That would be great. So hopefully.
Now you say that like you blanked the last one. I thought you won one the last
one. No, I'm pretty sure that I went 0-3. So.
Redemption for the rebellion time.
Right? I hope so. Because we talk a lot of smack. And overall, the rebellion's done pretty well. But at our first pay per view, we ate a big slice of humble pie. So.
Yeah, Hellion lost the Revolt X champion in the match. You know, Susie retained it. Gabby had to starlet over, and who else? And where's the other one?
It's nice how he just brings up this old stuff, right?
Yeah.
He's got it. That's awesome.
Yeah. There's another match in there. Hope beat the Deviant also. So.
There we go.
Them bum girls. I wonder who manages them girls. Bums.
Real.
Lucky. But here we go. So we got now, Scott, I got to ask, brother, because I every time I get on with some of the other, you know, podcasters that I have, you know, I always say, hey, you know what? This is one of the things I enjoy about my quote-unquote free agency, is that I get to travel to different leagues and, you know, interact with different managers, you know, going to the GNL and interacting with, you know, Wes and James, who are in a limited amount of leagues, going to, you know, the WWL, interacting with Melvin and, you know, limited managers that are there exclusively, you know, as like yourself, interacting with the IWAR, you know, faction and different managers that are, you know, not restricted, but that choose to play in those leagues, you know?
Sure. What's up?
And, you know, now coming to the RW and getting a taste of, you know, Brandon and Madden and Brandon and Sean, you know?
Yeah.
You know,
Brandon,
I was trying to say Madden.
Just leave me out, you know. That's
McAfee, and then that turned into Brandon and McAfee, and then.
Hey, listen, this podcast is all about Brandon and Madden, both of them.
I love it. Oh yeah. No, but just, you know, just getting the taste of different commissioners, getting a taste for different different trash talkers, you know, because, you know, like we know, we're angle based players. So,
right.
You know, I look for that. And I, you know, obviously I've tailored this last year on, you know, navigating myself to different, quote unquote, angle based leagues and working with these different managers, you know, and just, you know, getting your opinion as to, you know, a new feel or a new. You know, because you commission yourself.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Okay. I think I'm picking up what you're putting down. So in terms of like coming to a new place, right? However many cycles ago, I actually joined, maybe 7 or 8 or 9 now. I hadn't really met Sean or Brandon. I hadn't really talked to him. But I would say over the last however many cycles, half a year, I just really appreciate all their work and what the league is. And not to knock any of the other good leagues I'm in, because I only stay in leagues I enjoy, but taking out the leagues I commission, hot take, I think the RWL is probably my favorite league I'm in that I don't commission. I like what they do. I like the way the league is. I appreciate that they take women's wrestling seriously. I'm enjoying my characters. I'm enjoying our feuds. So I think the league is fantastic, which is kind of why, well, I'll leave that part out. But just I enjoy the league a lot. So you talk about like coming in and meeting like new people or traveling around. Somebody who maybe hasn't invested in women's characters before, maybe hasn't been in bronze, maybe people that don't know Sean and Brandon. It's a, for whatever it's worth, it's a ringing endorsement for me. I really enjoy the RWL. So that's that.
Oh, yeah.
So, we definitely appreciate that, without a doubt, your endorsement. And, you know, it's funny just because, like, when you meet new people, I mean, obviously that led to us going to the UNL, which me and Sean have both had a good time, and Flip as well. We've all enjoyed kind of, you know, being there with you.
I'm not in the UNL.
Oh, sorry. Hey, Flip's not in there. But anyways, listen, you don't need to know who my associates are. But, seriously, though, it is cool to, you know, to meet the new characters, meet the new people, you know, and just the fellow trash talkers. Seems like we're kind of a dying breed, so it's cool, you know, all of us to stick together and just good times.
Oh, yeah. Especially trash talk, that makes sense.
Yeah. I've mentioned it before with Flip on here, is just like, you know, if it was just sending in matches for the sake of sending in matches, I probably wouldn't even be in the IWA, because it's all about, to me, it's all about the trash talk. And if I win something, I win something. That's cool, but it's more so about the storylines and keeping the characters going. And yeah, that's what I dig.
Oh yeah. Now, I mean, and you know, where else are you going to get to go up against, you know, Slammerella? I mean, the bagged wonder. Oh man.
Inner bag people.
The bag people are coming. Now, you know, rumors are floating. And Scott, you tell me what you've heard behind the scenes, but rumors are that she's not that ugly, and it's just the nasty Bonita and Lucy, who, you know, come across all nice and cutesy, that are actually behind all this, I guess. So rumors leading up to the pay per view are that, you know, yeah, she's not as horrendous as people are saying. So see what happens after this pay-per-view.
That does seem to be the latest rumor, is that Slammerella is not a person who is unattractive. So
and here she is going up against Amanda Love from The Beautiful People. So
they've been giving her hell.
Yeah, been giving her a hard time, you know. I think what was it that you said, Sean, that at one of the events that you were at, you know, someone ripped off one of the bags that she had, you know, which, you know, normally has a nice smile on, and
I'm ready to kick your ass face on.
eyebrows were drawn down, and man, I was, oh man, I'm telling you. So Amanda, watch out.
When the eyebrows on the bag change, you know business is about to pick up.
Exactly. All right, this just in.
Uh-oh.
It's been finalized. Babs Capone versus Vlada Morozov will be the next match. And Frankie is hanging over the center of the ring. So whoever gets Frankie is,
to use Frankie?
To use it.
Get to use
Frankie. Oh, man.
Now,
Commissioner Goldstein just finalized them two.
Nice. Now, Scott, I mean, I know you came on a little, you know, towards the end of the year, so you may have missed some of the Frankie angle, but, you know, Frankie was a big part of the introduction to our RWL. I mean, he was, you know, a big part of some of those angles. It escalated in Frankie getting taken by Chimera Roo. Chimera stole Frankie.
And right, Frankie is Babs' baseball bat, right?
Yes.
See, I mean, I know a little. I know a little.
Yeah, so this baseball bat gets taken, and, you know, Chimera, you know, who, you know, hangs around, you know, another member of the NRA, Caspian, who is just has spells galore. And so I honestly think that when Chimera took Frankie, they somehow put a spell on Frankie that has caused Babs to kind of, you know, act up a little bit, because yeah, she hasn't been the same. Like, yeah, so she actually tried to burn Frankie recently, and Vlada, you know, Vlada's like, you know, hey, you airhead, you can't burn that, you know, if something's bad's gonna happen if you burn that, you know, it's like, no, don't do that. So I'm curious, as you know, maybe Vlada wants to get that bat to save Babs from doing something that, you know, would eventually just, you know, harm her, do her more harm than good. So I'm curious as to where that escalates.
Yeah, we just gotta wait and see after the pay-per-view.
Oh yeah. Oh, now this one I've been waiting for. Let me tell you. Lady Fango versus Alexa Rose. Now, have we heard? Has Alexa sold the Fango yet? Has she got her? She cashed out on that painting.
No, that's hanging in Goldstein's office.
Yeah, that's nice. Hanging in Goldstein's office.
Yeah. Oh, so Alexis didn't even get to take it.
No.
Nice.
That's a Go original right there.
Oh man, Goldstein, that bastard kept it.
Goldstein used to manage Fango.
Yeah, that's why I said. Oh man.
Yeah, this is gonna be a good one. But definitely Alexis Rose, former world heavyweight champion. It's gonna be tough. But it's gonna be I think they're gonna put on a hell of a match.
Yeah. Now correct me if I'm wrong, but Lady was left off the last pay-per-view with a knee injury.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yeah.
So she was still recovering from her.
She was a little mad at Goldstein because when she kind of, for like a year plus, she would not speak. And the first person to make her speak was Gabby Wonder, who made her tap out and say, I quit. So, Goldstein kind of, you know, didn't want to risk her injuring her knee anymore. Mm-hmm. And it kind of pissed off Lady Fango that she was left off the first major pay-per-view.
Right.
So she took it out on Alexis.
Yes,
and here
yes,
we are.
She did.
Wrong place, right time, I guess. Yeah.
Right.
Oh man. Oh yeah. Now this one. Now, if I was waiting for that one, dude, I got my popcorn. You know, I saved my popcorn for this one.
Oh yeah.
Man, this war game, especially now that I understand that it's going to be in a double cage, submitter surrender type of style. Holy, I'm just worried. You know, something's going to come from under the ring, because you know when you got, you know, the Gores and all their worshiping and all their, you know, yeah, you talk about, you know, giving a reader the creeps. Yeah. Well done there, by the way. Like, what is she doing?
I mean, like, I would write it and it would creep me out. I'm like, man.
Like, what are you doing?
Weird. Oh, what is wrong with me? Like, this.
You know,
and the more we keep adding to it, it's just crazier and crazier. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's like, it's on those, it's on one of the souvenirs, top sellers, you know, those damn little voodoo dolls right next to the bags.
Yes.
Right next to the mini bags and the duplicate goes, and you know, all the little blood moons that they're selling. I'm telling you, man, this place is rocking. You know, oh man.
You know, I will tell you this. And so, kind of before the Gores came in, I mean, literally right before they came in, Acid and Venus debuted, and they kind of hit the page a few times, and they won the World Tag, the World Six. They were kind of dominating, and then the Gores came in and just kind of ripped all that away from them.
Oh, yeah.
The Gores have been dominating. So it's kind of like, okay, you know, they've been going back and forth. They fought the last pay-per-view, and now, I mean, how do you – what better way to settle it but inside?
Yeah, Venus and Acid beat Amaris and Trish at the last pay-per-view, but Winter beat Aya.
That's what I was going to say. I was just going to say they went 1-1 at the last pay-per-view, right? Yeah. So this is kind of the rubber match.
Yep.
Nice.
On top of that, though, I mean, not even just in ring. Yeah. I mean, if you look what the Gores have done to Susie Moon and, you know, what in turn has happened to Aya out of the whole deal.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Here I have a character like Aya Rathbone. I mean, granddaughter of Nixon. You got, you know, a history with that character. You know, just, I mean, when we did the crossover from the MML into the RWL, I just remember that build of that character. And, you know, a character like that just, to me, stands out as a, as, you know, one of those, you know, franchise characters. And just to see her kind of get overwhelmed by all this, like, new talent. And, you know, I think we talked about it when we started doing these podcasts. You know, we started pouting, you know, we're like, hey, we're mentioning these Gorns a lot. We're mentioning these. Right.
Winter had Susie Moon, unbeknownst to herself, attack Aya not once but twice. And Susie didn't remember it until it was brought up. They actually found out.
So that's starting to unravel on Winter.
Yeah.
Because now Susie knows.
We joked about, you know, the rough cycle and everything this past month, but the Winter Gore has been on a tear lately.
Yes. Oh, yeah. I mean, all the go. I mean, like I said, I mean,
a cycle.
Yeah. And, you know, like you just mentioned right now, Brandon, I mean, that's one of those things that I enjoy. And, you know, breaking the fourth wall a little bit, you know, working with you guys all, you know, on this air is just the way I can already see that match. Like, even though the pay-per-view is still five cycles away, in the back of my head, I'm like, dude, I can already see you two guys, you know, like I said, I know I'm jumping ahead, but I got one of those, like, fast-forward deja vu. I can't even call it a deja vu. More like a fast-forward preview of the future. Like, wow, I can already see the Susie Moon freaking Winter Gourmet.
Yeah, that's a premonition.
You know,
there you go. Sean, I love it. I love it when, you know, I know there's got to be a word for this. There you go, premonition. I love it. Yeah.
You know what? I will say that while I am brave enough to sometimes journey into Sean's dark, twisted mind, I can tell you that nobody is going to even begin to expect what's going on next.
Aha, I love it.
I'm not spoiling anything, but
enough said. Like, Flip, shut up. Shut up. That's my cue.
Oh, there's stuff that you don't know, Flip.
Of course. That's what I love about this, man. Dude, tell me, Mike, when I'm opening up the button, then all of a sudden I see those extra Facebook matches. I'm like, nice, we got more matches? Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you something, Flip. If this makes you feel any better, Sean, we've known each other since how old, probably? I mean, I'm 40 now, and we were probably what?
I mean, like 14.
Even earlier. Man.
Nine before that, yeah. Yeah. That we started and, first.
Yeah, and I will say this, that when Aya joined the RWL, he didn't even tell me Aya was his character. He's like, hey, you know that character that's won like titles 2 months in a row? Hey, it was Aya. She's mine.
Oh, that's good to know. I all this time, I thought, oh, dude, so now you're probably going to tell me that he runs Nixon also.
No, Nixon's mine.
I thought I had that square. So I had Aya pinned as yours also, do you see? Learn something new every podcast.
But there's a lot to come, and to apologize to Gaddy in advance, you guys will shit your pants when you see what's coming.
Oh, dude, what is Miss Goody Two Shoes done to you, Andy?
Let me get my $5 out and put it in the jar. $5.
Right. And also, those swear jars are selling really well in the concessions.
Right.
Nice.
Yes, because we are all about maximizing the merchandise in the RWL.
Oh, you know it. Parents everywhere are buying their swear jobs.
Yeah.
Anytime, like, mom, like, well, you're paying for the next Royal Rumble with your swears.
Hey,
that wouldn't be a good incentive. No, the kid would start cussing I don't even want to say it. I was about to owe money, more money.
Yeah, you got to teach kids about money early. So.
Right. Hey, you know what, too, is speaking of, like, you know, maximizing the income, I do got to talk God Anderson afterwards about the inflatable wheelchairs in the UNL.
I love it.
Ezekiel is going to be seeking some compensation for that backstage attack.
Without a doubt.
There you go. There you go. That's a good way to pay off. Like, you know what? Let's strike a deal. There you go. Inflatable wheelchairs. Holy moly.
But they but make after, wheelchairs after... now that stand you up, you know?
Oh, dang. Like, is that... I don't yeah, I'm going to jail if I say no. I won't say
Oh, so going man. Back to what we were talking about, the Gores versus
the Gores, you
know,
yes,
the NRA.
Oh, I love it.
In all honesty, yes, I think this is the only match that could have main evented this show because I'm very excited for this show. Last show, Sean did a great job. I think I mentioned this before. He did an awesome job coming up with the matches, but this time it seems even more special because of the fact that a lot of it, or most of it, is from the Trash Talk. Yes. And the Gores, this is 2 months in a row that we have been feuding with them. And I mean, I look forward to seeing what comes out of this. And it's just, it's going to be awesome because like the Gores are awesome. Like I said, my character, Malik the Mad, his favorite wrestlers without a doubt. And yeah, this is going to be awesome. War Games, submission or surrender.
And I will mention that the Revolt X title will be defended at... on the Facebook page.
Nice. Okay.
Their Thursday show.
Nice. I like it.
Yes. Whenever we figure out who the champion is, right?
Yes. Well, we know so far that Elsa Frost, she won the Battle Royal. Winter Gore, she won the Contender X. I mean, but now we're trying to see who actually won. We know it's between Susie Moon and Elsa Hurst. One of those two yes. are the champions. So
we got Winter Gore, who has dominated since she came in here. We got Elsa Hurst, who's a former world heavyweight champion. And we got Susie Moon, who's six times, if I'm correct.
Six times at this time right now, yeah.
I mean, you couldn't ask for three better people in that match.
Yeah. Nice. I like it. You know what? I mean, like I said, new turns and new twists at every angle, brother. I love it.
Yeah, it keeps things secret, you know. So.
Yeah, could no, always, that's
could always make it a fatal four-way if somebody had a draw with the champion.
That's true. That's what I'm waiting to. That's what I'm waiting to find out.
Yeah.
Who had a point flow or that are actually tied? You know. So.
I got you.
And that's what's cool too is just like we're kind of seeing different things now. Like Sky Rose that won the Battle Royal and the Contenders X. Yeah. So she was able to get the first ever one-on-one match, singles, you know. Yeah.
Now, I'm going to go ahead and break the, you know, I don't know why I got in the habit of saying breaking the fourth wall every time I'm going to mention something about the IWA, but I mean, it's one of those things, Sean, where like, I mean, you're still a relatively new commissioner. So, you know, people have to know that, hey, you know what, you're going to encounter times, you're going to encounter, you know, Scott, you're going on your, you said, 200th report now?
I think you're giving me a few more than I've earned. I started in the LNL almost 2 years ago. I started in the UNL about a year and a half ago, and I took over the CWL just under a year ago.
So 2 years, 34,
so you think like 30 and 30 and 12, so I'm somewhere between 70 and 80 reports.
Why do I suck at math all of a sudden? Isn't there 17 and 17, right? So you did 2 years, so that's 37 and or 34 and 34.
Yeah.
That's 68. Right. And you just started. Yeah, my math is way off. I'm like, way
off.
Come on,
numbers guy.
Fuck, forget that. Okay. Yeah.
You know, though, I think Flip just plays humble with us because he wins an awful lot for somebody who says
he doesn't
do numbers or doesn't care about his strats. And I'm like, you win an awful lot, sir.
The ultimate sandbagger. Nice.
Hey, I will say this, though, I'm not biased at all because I am not in the LNL, but the head in the box match is possibly the greatest gimmick match of all time.
Well, thank you.
No problem.
I was just trying to think, I'm like, how can I spin Money in the Bank And it just, I don't know, it just hit me like a ton of bricks, you know, head in the box. So
you should have seen my face when I was reading it, and I was like,
oh, the pay-per-view itself?
Yeah. I was like, that's not the way I expected the damn head in the box match to start. Like, they literally chopped this one dude's head off and put it in a box. I'm like, what? They don't sell pre-ordered, you know, heads in a box? Like, you can't just pre-order one? Like, with it.
I picture this old school, like, Clash of the Champions or Clash of the Titans kind of deal, where they yank the head, Medusa's head out of the bag, you know?
Yeah.
And then suddenly cash it in. Take the head, you know.
Oh man, I can't wait for that cash in either, brother. But
I was just saying, has that person cashed the thing in yet?
They have not. They have not. The winner was a character, Sinister Bagul, and he has not cashed in yet. So, 4-point advantage whenever he chooses to cash in. So,
yeah. Oh, speaking about advantage, the NRA does have a 2-point advantage over the Gores.
Because they won the captain's match.
Captain's match, yes.
Now, help me out here. And for those who may not know, also, is this going to be a six-person match? Is this going to be
pretty much. It'll be, I'll just add up all the points.
So it'll be single strats added up.
Yep.
Okay. Single strats added up. Okay.
Yep. Yeah. So basically, if you think about the old War Games matches, how it was like the 5-on-5. And
right.
And, you know, you the next guy would come in, you'd get the advantage, and...
Right.
That would be the kind of deal. So technically, storyline wise, you know, the Acid Rain has the choice to choose if they're gonna let a Gore go in first or if they're gonna go in first to the match.
Interesting.
So it's all about strategy.
Gotcha. Okay. So three individual strats added up.
Yes.
Okay, perfect.
So if Venus is in there and Acid decides to send another Gore in there first, you know. Venus can't be pissed at Acid. She's got to understand that there's strategy in this.
Right.
Yeah, I think it gives a better advantage if you're doing three single, you know, adding them up, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody can get like a 498, so the other one a 492s, you know. Yeah.
Okay. Now, I know I'm slow, but so... If who's starting the match? You said Winter and Aya are starting the match?
No, we don't know yet.
Do I don't think we even really announced who's starting yet. So that'll be up to Scott who starts for him, and that'll be up to Sean and myself who starts for.
Nice.
For us. Yes.
Now,
the write-up.
That's what I was kind of hunting for. That's what I was. Okay, so that stuff, you know, obviously behind the scenes stuff that, you know, after the match is over, we'll work out the write ups and work out that.
You know what?
More likely to be the two people with the lowest strats.
Gotcha.
They'll probably start it off, you know.
And while we're talking about the write ups, I did mention, like, I talked to Scott, and he sent me some pictures of who the Gores look like. I talked to a few other managers as well. We're kind of trying to do a nice little write-up here with pictures and everything involved. So, like I said, like we've actually, like all of us have said on the message board, you know, feel free to post pictures of your wrestlers or send them to us. And, you know, it'll just make it look better, look cool. You know, of course, I'm going to pawn all of that off onto Flip. Make no mistake, it's going all on him.
Yeah, Flip said he's doing all the write-ups this time.
I got it. No, not the write-ups. I'll do the posters. You don't want my writings.
Anybody wants to send in anything, you know, anything about your characters, like what type of moves they use or anything like that, or whatever you want them to do in the match, feel free to send all that in. We will include that, and we will try and make it as cool as it can possibly be.
Nice. I love it. Now, Sean, I know, I said, is there anything else we want to add on this preview, kind of to hint to throw hints towards the managers and stuff, you know, that they might want to?
No, not really. Just be prepared for changing your underwear.
I like it. Keep a fresh pair nearby. Keep a fresh pair nearby. Oh man, Brandon, anything else on this one?
You know what? Last thing I'll say is shout out to all the InterFed podcasts. make sure you check all of them out. You know, the Salvation ones, the Wicked Wars League, all those guys, check all of them out. Mr. Anderson is headed to the I War podcast after this, or the TubeCast. Check those out too. Yeah, just support everything IWA.
Shout out, double shout out to that. Mr. Anderson, any last words on this preview show?
Well, we had talked a few times about maybe getting the four of us all together on a show. I'm glad that we were able to do it tonight. I appreciate being invited on. RWL is a great place to play if you're looking for something new. Obviously, again, I highly recommend giving it a look. So that's my last word.
I love it. Well, guys, you've been listening to the Goddesses of War preview show with Commissioner Sean McAbee, Brandon Madden, and special guest Commissioner of the UNL and LNL, and War Coordinator, Mr. Scott Anderson. As for myself, IWA Flip, we'll see you guys next time. Take care.
See ya.
See you at the War Games.